Hello everyone. So today we will discuss about PERT evaluation and review technique in this video. Now framework for PERT. So this is similar like framework for critical path method which we have already discussed in part 3rd of this video. So the key concept used by CPM PERT is that a small set of activities which make up the longest path through the activity network control the entire project. If these critical activities could be identified and assigned to responsible person, management resources could be optimally used by concentrating on the few activities which determine the fate of the entire project. So non-critical activities can be replanned, rescheduled and resourced for them can be reallocated flexibly without affecting the whole project. So when work is delegated like this, the need for constant feedback and coordination becomes an important senior management precautions. So drawing the CPM or PERT network, we have already discussed in our previous video. Now we will discuss the framework for PERT. So manageable tasks is one in which the expected result can be easily identified. Success, failure or completion of the task can be easily ascertained. The time to complete the task can be easily estimated and the resource requirement of the task can be easily determined. So program evaluation and review technique charts shows task duration and dependency information. So each chart starts with an initiation node from which the first task or task originates. If multiple tasks begin at the same time, they are all started from the node or branch. Each task is represented by a line which states its name or other identifier, its duration, the number of people assigned to it. And in the same case, the initiation of the personnel assigned, the other end of the task line is terminated by another node, which identified the start of the another task or beginning of any slack time, that is waiting time between tasks. Each task is connected to its successor task in this manner, forming a network of nodes and connecting lines. The chart is completed or complete when all final tasks come together at the completion node. When slack time exists between the end of the one task and the start of another, the usual method is to draw a broken or dotted line between the end of the first task and the start of the next dependent task. A PERT chart may have multiple parallel or interconnecting networks of tasks. If the scheduled project has milestone, checkpoints or review points, the PERT chart will note that the all tasks up to that point terminate at the review node. When drawing up the plan, be sure to include tasks for documentation writing, documentation editing, project report writing and editing, and the report reproduction. So these tasks are usually time consuming, so don't underestimate how long it will be take to complete them. PERT charts are usually drawn on ruled paper with a horizontal axis indicate the time period, division in days, weeks, month and so on. Although it is possible to draw a PERT chart for an entire project, the usually practice is to break the plan into smaller, more meaningful parts. This is very helpful if the chart has to be redrawn for any reason, such as skipped or incorrectly estimated task. So many PERT charts terminate at the major review points, such as at the end of the analysis. Many organizations include funding reviews in the project life cycle. Where this is the case, each task terminates in the funding review node. So through this video, we can understand some basic guidelines for draw any PERT network. So thanks for watching this video.